Gonna say
can walk together.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm at the Swan Valley community. Behind me now, they've got some homemade roads down here, and there's people down here living, homeless people are living down here at the back of the community. That's okay, but as long as they keep the area clean and look after down there, get out of there before it rains and find another safe spot. But yeah, don't say nothing to them. Let them go. But my main concern is that you've got motorbikes coming down here, making motorbike tracks down here. So this is at the back of the Swan Valley community down here today. Home. Yeah. And down there in the back, at the back of this community, they used to have a gathering with a grandfather, Tommy Brofo, and a group of elders would get down there and do a crobbery. The crobbery started from there, then up towards Lockridge Shops. So this is the beginning of the heart, what we call the heart. You have your crobbery grounds, you have your meeting grounds. But the city of Swan and the city of Bazandine don't recognise that history. They recognise Heather Blackfellas who are in there, who has never lived in the area, who went away from and left their grandmothers and their grandfathers to live a better life, and they grew up, then they come back and they think they are still the custodian owners of this area. It belongs to all Noongar people. Noongar, then Whadjuk came. But if that's the game they want to play, well, my grandmother was from down south. She's a Whadjuk woman. My mother is Edna Nettles, who's a Noongar woman. And she married my father, Robert Brofo. And then, so that's the beginning of the Brofo family. And Edna Nettles lived here all her life. But they'd rather recognise the other blackfellas that come in. When we do good things, they recognise them. And there's a lot of coconuts here in the Swan Valley, Bazandine, and the Swan, and middle, up in Midland at the Shires. They don't want to sit down and talk to people like human beings. They want to take over and destroy. But yeah, good on you. If you're homeless down here and you've got nowhere to stay, yeah, be safe, because that gets flooded.